Hey guys, back with another video, and today we have another AC News video for you guys today. I'm recording this on Christmas Day, but I have not been feeling well lately. If you can't tell, my voice is a little shot. I just haven't been feeling well all around. Which sucks, but Christmas, for the most part, was not terrible. Not the greatest Christmas of all time, but there's more surprises to come around, and today was not bad. Got some cool gifts and all that. I don't know if I'll do a Christmas haul, because, I don't know, just nothing crazy to show off. But, yeah, so let's get straight to the week 17 previews. Oh my gosh. See, my voice, like, I can barely talk. Okay. Starting with the Thursday game, you have the Cowboys at the Titans. Then the Sunday games, you have the Broncos at the Chiefs, the Browns at the Commanders, the Steelers at the Ravens, the Cardinals at the Falcons, the Colts at the Giants, the Bears at the Lions, the Jags at the Texans, the Carolina Panthers at the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, the Dolphins at the Patriots, the Saints at the Eagles, the 49ers at the Raiders, the Jets at the Seahawks, the Minnesota Vikings at my Green Bay Packers. Sunday night game, you have the Rams at the Chargers. And then Monday game, you have the Bills at the Bengals. Quickly going over the NFL Week 16 scores and results this past week in the NFL. Another pretty insane week, as it was a Christmas week here in the NFL. It is the next day that I'm recording this part. I mean, if you guys don't know, I always record the scores and results the next day from when I record the previews. I record the previews Sunday and then record these Monday after the Monday night game, obviously. And I'm still, like, slightly a little sick, but we're still going to get through this video. So, oh my gosh. Getting to the Thursday game, you had the Jags getting the win over the Jets 19-3. You had a lot of Saturday games for Christmas Eve. The Ravens getting a win over the Falcons 17-9. The Lions taking a tough L to the Panthers 37-23. The Chiefs getting a win over the Seahawks 24-10. The Saints getting a big win over the Browns 17-10. Bengals barely squeaking out a win 22-18 towards the Patriots. The Vikings hitting a 61-yard field goal to win the game. They can't keep getting away with this. Beating the Giants 27-24. The Bills absolutely murdering the Bears 35-13. The Texans getting the upset probably of the year 19-14 towards the Titans. Their first win in forever. Only their second win on the season. The Niners get the win over the Commanders 37-20. The Cowboys barely getting a win over the Eagles 40-34. Eagles had Minshew mania. And then Saturday night game, you had the Steelers getting the win over the Raiders 13-10. Then for a couple Sunday games, you had the Rams murdering the Broncos. And when I say murder, I say murder. The Broncos 51-14. and one of the worst Sunday night games of all time. The Bucks getting the win over the Cardinals, 19-16. The Chargers getting the win over the Colts, 20-3 on Monday Night Football. And for my Packers postgame on a Sunday night game, you had my Green Bay Packers getting a huge win in Miami. Nobody thought we could do it, but we get a big one, 26-20. I mean, just honestly a big upset. Dolphins were kind of winning the entire time. They were up 20-10, but we were able to make a comeback and get the win. I'm sorry. I can barely speak right now, but Tua throwing like 3 interceptions, which is reminiscent to last year on Christmas Day when Baker on the Browns threw us 4 interceptions on Christmas in the win. But this time it was Tua with 3. And just a very solid game. Christian Watson sadly getting hurt during it. Along with, there's another guy. Oh, I forgot who it was. I can't remember. Someone on defense. Oh, Keyshawn Nixon. That's right. Keyshawn Nixon played well, too, with like a 90-yard return at one point. Very solid dub here. Love to see it. The Packers' playoff hopes are still alive, especially with big-time losses from the Commanders, from the Giants, from the Seahawks, from the Lions, all teams we needed to lose, and they all lost, which is just win-win situation for us. We have a tough game next week against the Vikings. It'll be real tough. That'll be our biggest challenge yet. If we can win that one, it's looking bright for playoff hopes for the Green Bay Packers. I didn't think we would be able to. After the Eagles loss earlier this season, I thought we were done for. But you're telling me there's a chance. You're telling me there is a chance. And there is. So hopefully the Green Bay Packers can pull through and squeak out a playoff berth. And finishing this video off with my fantasy football winning or losing. It was an interesting week in week 16. Playoffs still happening. Starting with my league on the left. My actually important league that I needed to win this week. I think I was down at the start of this game, but I was able to come out with a big old dub, and I'm going to the fantasy championship for back-to-back years now. You'll have to see it. You really do. Gardner Minshew mania, baby. Zonovan Knight, the big disappointer of the week, but you know, it'd be like that. Keenan Allen did solid as always. AJ Brown as always. Travis Kelce as always. Mari Cooper did exactly how I thought he would do. Ravens defense performed well. And of course, so did Justin Tucker. So overall, amazing week on all the spectrum. Just got a big win there and going to the fantasy championship again. And getting to my family league on the right kind of depicts how this entire season has gone. Just not great. Not great at all. Just didn't have anyone crazy. I mean, AJ Brown did fine. Amon-Ra did fine, but nothing like crazy. Gerald Everett got 0. Like, that's disappointing. And then Herbie also didn't do the greatest of all time. So just not a great game once again from this league. It's pretty much been terrible all around in this league. entire season. Yeah. So, I hope you guys enjoyed this video today. Please comment, like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you know when I post a new video. Bye, guys.